Vulnerable groups such as people with disabilities, elderly people, people in places of detentions and other institutions, migrants, homeless people, they have limited access to products, social services, to rehabilitation and accessible information. We also noticed the increased incidence of domestic violence, limited access to food and water, especially in the rural areas, increasing hate speech, discrimination, xenophobia, both in the media and social media towards migrants, ethnic minorities, and people with COVID-19. And the last one, limited freedom of speech, movement, freedom of press, and lack of market. The pandemic has taught us that there are many ways in which we can use human rights as tools to navigate through the pandemic. It has taught us how crucial an early action and collaboration between the citizens and the authorities is to prevent a catastrophic consequence. It has taught us to go local, to sustain local producers, to work from home, to limit consumption to what we need. And what really matters is the same for all of us. It's actually the health and safety of our family and our loved ones. I believe that we must respect human rights and stand together not only against the coronavirus pandemic, but also in our daily life.